because they will think that time is their time for life. By telling a child, oh, you're silly, don't do that, you're silly. What you say is, mommy said I'm silly, I'm going to be silly for the rest of my life. What you say to a person is, I actually don't like what you're doing, but I still love you despite what you're doing. That way they have a strong foundation to carry on their lives.
And they
will carry on as confident adults, right from childhood to grow up as confident adults. Take care of your body. Don't worry about shape, size, big, small, fat, whatever. Your body is your body. And wear your body with pride. Be confident. Dance like if nobody else will do. Don't worry about size 6, because a size 6 is a Barbie doll fish. It's not a healthy fish. And like for an 11-year-old to be worried about what their shape and their size is, that's tragic. Very, very tragic. We need to tell our children they're beautiful. We need to tell ourselves and each other, you're beautiful the way you are. Surround yourselves with good people. My vibe attracts my tribe. And I have found that out of years since I opened up about my own mental health experiences, that my vibe is attracting good people and supportive people around me. Unfortunately, I suicided 3 times in my life. And that was from not having anybody to talk to. Too often we're there and we just say, oh, we're fine. How are you today? I'm fine, Brad. How many people actually turn around and say, how are you really? How deep down, how are you really? Behind that makeup, how are you? I have a good friend and I don't meet him maybe every 6 months, maybe once a year. And he's had taller than me, and he'll put, make me look up, and he'll turn again, and he'll say, Bernie, how are you? I mean, how are you deeply, really? And he won't turn away. You won't look away, because he won't allow it until you actually confide and say, well, you know what, this is bad, this is not working out. Or, yeah, when he believes you're truly fine, that's when he'll drop the book. That's when you can say, okay, I'm glad you're well, I'm glad you're happy. Learn how to deal with stress. That's a lot of our problem. We don't learn how to deal with stress. We end up exploding. One of my experiences when I committed suicide, I was so stressed out. I was living in a studio apartment in Dublin, thinking that there was nobody there to support me. Between me going and work, and having all the bills to pay myself, I was so stressed out. I didn't know how to cope with my stress. I just thought that by alleviating everything myself, that I could solve the problems. I was going to be able to fix it. I was going to fix the problem at work. I deal with my money. I was going to fix the problem at home. I deal with everything that was happening in my apartment block. But it got too much because my stress building up inside me. And like a grenade, I exploded and I walked out of my job. That made my stress worse. Because then when I came back, when I worked back after my overdose, I had to prove to the company that I was more than capable to walk back into my job. But what I did, I learned to deal with my stress by going for walks. It might have been a long walk, but it was my time. Even during my lunch hour, instead of sitting in the canteen, listen to all that negativity from everybody else and listen to everybody else's problems, I would get up and I'd say, you know what, I'm just going over to the park, I'm going for a walk. That could be maybe 5 or 10 minutes. I'd ride my bicycle and I'd go up to the cycle into Phoenix Park. I do a mad dash down to Phoenix Park and back up out to that bar again. even to have head space, when you won't have a ballot, lock the door so the children can't get in. Explain to the children, mummy needs time right now. You go and listen to your news. Go and colour your books. They need to know, children need to know that parents need space so that they can be better parents as well to them. Quiet our minds. We have to find our own space, our own solitude, to have to bring down our minds from a day of hard day's work. I find music is great, and through music, I have made friends worldwide. Somebody said to me one time that Facebook is rubbish, that it's just a waste of time. It's not. You meet valuable, lifelong friends on Facebook. I've never had one. I went to London about 2 years ago for the first time. I didn't have a clue where I was going. All I knew was I had to find the soul bar, and I had to find a group of Africans as well. Suddenly, I connected with one friend, and I said to my friend, "Don't leave me alone when I meet you. Just go into the bar." So he went in and I followed in and I said, like, what is this? Where's the African convention? There's nobody else, only a group of Africans in the corner of the bar. And they said, no, this is the old music club. There are music groups on Facebook that deal with every kind of music. You can have jazz, you can have old school, you can have ages. There's the only secretary's music group as well. Every night after work, I would switch on my laptop, and whatever my mood was, I would pick my group that night. And even though I was in my apartment listening to music by myself, the banter on the Facebook page meant that I also had company. And if I wasn't active, but they could see that I was online, somebody would always reach out. Are you okay? Are you enjoying the music tonight? You're very quiet. How was your day? And all I had to do was say, I'm fine. I actually don't feel like talking now. I'm just enjoying the music. And then everybody else would know that I was there because this person that inboxed me would say, yes, she's fine, she's okay. And we would do that with each other. Not just people dealing with me. Everybody would do that. And through these music groups, we got a what we needed, our quietness at the end of the day. And we also got contact and friendship worldwide through music and like something innocent like that. Session goals. Our goals in life have to be realistic. There's no point in waking up and saying, oh, I'm going to be the president of Ireland today. We have to set realistic goals for ourselves. I was dreadful. I'd start a course and I just wouldn't finish them because we were way beyond what I need. But everybody would say, oh, you have to study, you have to go to the next level. But nobody ever actually said, I take this level, this is as far as I do when you can go, or like, you have to reach for your level. At the moment, I have found my level. I have discovered what I want to do. And while I hold down my job, I'm a butcher. While I hold down my full-time job as a butcher, I'm also studying social studies and counseling skills. I did psychology years ago when my children were small. And I want to go back to that because my heart is in helping other people. That's my goal. That's my level. And also, don't be told by anybody that you're incapable of doing anything. Because everybody is capable of doing what they want to do. If you want something bad enough, the sky is not your limit. It's the last ceiling that you will break as you reach for the stars. Everybody has hidden talents. Nobody knows what anybody else is capable of. I was told by a maths teacher in school that I would never achieve anything because I wasn't able to do maths. I was socially hopeless at maths. That teacher in